Okay, so both of the captains just rolled a 5 on the dice spin. I don't think this was planned, because normally it's heads or tails. Then we've moved to a dice, and they both just rolled it again.
Lord almighty.
Now, I want to clarify, they rolled the same thing on a D100. D100. And then the second time around, they rolled a 1 and a 5. They rolled single digits both times. What in the hell? What? Huh?
They do not have very good rolls.
And now they're rolling by percents. That's not how a dice works. Yes.
Center got an 82% though.
The hell sort of dice are those?
It looks like Poland won that.
Okay, Poland won, just in general. We've already seen it. We've already seen the game. Poland actually wins the World Cup.
Yeah.
As well as France.
It has been confirmed by the dice roll.
France won the entire World Cup in the previous match. This match, Poland wins the entire World Cup. Eventually, we'll just get to multiple.
Pretty much. I'm looking forward to seeing Poland sweep all the other teams.
Right. I don't know. I honestly, right now, I do not think these picks and bans are going to matter very much.
Sadly.
Okay, we just need to get some support in chat for Poland, because they're going to need all the support they can get here. This is very much a unfair matchup, I think is the best way to put it. But you never know. I think if they can take a match off of the US, they should be happy. Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
I reckon morally, if they take a match off the US, they win. I reckon they are going to ban Esoteria again. I just know it's going to happen, I think.
Probably. The first ban is actually Sugary.
What? Huh? Okay.
Yeah, Poland
banned
Sugary.
That was by Poland, right?
Yeah,
huh.
It was by Poland.
That is confusing. I am very confused. Wait, what do they have to gain from banning Sugary?
The United States banned Army.
Yeah, that one. See, that one I can see, because that one's more tech hack. Mm-hmm. So, given that they have so many tech players, that's definitely one of their like second or first choices as far as Poland was concerned. But I don't really know where they're gonna go from here.
Okay, so US picked GOAT for their first map. And the players are going to be Serret, Schwenk, Lucas, and Estrella.
Yeah, so all of the players they've got in there are completely fine with anything more techy.
So the Cowboy's already up?
The Cowboy is out. He's just up and ready.
Seeing GOAT as the first pick is interesting. It's right in the middle of everything.
Also, for anyone wondering, Luxus has asked to be referred to as the Cowboy, so...
As he appears on
the leaderboard. That is the reason for this.
If you ever see that random cowboy-looking emote on leaderboards, it's probably him now.
It is Luxus. Guaranteed.
Guaranteed.
Oh, the Polish-Spanish chat. We have the Polish support. We have some cowboy support going in there. The Cowboys all coming out. They're here.
This is a very wide map. And like we said, it's kind of a hybrid between the more mid-range and faster maps and like lower ACK maps. Because it's hard, but it's definitely ACKable for some people. Especially the people in this match, probably. I expect to see some people in the US get 96 and above.
Yeah, I'm expecting just in general the accuracy here to be about at least 3 of the US players holding a really good score, and then one possibly 2 of the Polish players, mainly looking at Dracono there.
I feel prediction-wise that I'm not for sure about Schwenk's AK, because I can't remember how good his AK is, but overall, I feel like their average will probably be close to a 96, if not a 96 for US.
Well, I'm not sure about a 96 for Schwenk. I don't think his AK is the best. Yeah,
Schwenk is the only one I'm thinking like about tech. When it comes to AK.
Yeah, but he's very much a fan of tech, though. So.
I feel like we're going to probably see a miss or two, because it is a little bit of a hard-to-focus map.
Chat wars are incoming. Yeah, this is what we've been waiting for the entire time. This is what we've been waiting for between the matches.
The green screens. Well, here we go. Schwenk's, of course, got his cursor on screen.
Hell yeah, dang. That's what we like to see.
Oh, boy. Right now, of course, they're close because it's just the little intro. Oh, boy.
Okay.
Hearing that slow start.
Yeah, it's... I think just through the start bit, it's not going to be too bad for anyone, I don't think. Possibly the occasional miss. You can see Fnite's not actually...
Yeah, there's like one or two parts that, if you're not focusing, you could accidentally miss.
Yeah, we can already see that difference in AK is just massive.
Schwenk's got pretty good accuracy right now.
Yeah, I don't think I've ever actually seen Schwenk playing anything more AK-y before.
That was my concern, because I honestly have no clue how good his AK is, which right now it's up there.
he is not worrying about AK at all, I would say. Currently, the only person that seems to be down is Knight, who somewhere along the line has had a miss, which is definitely dragging him down a bit more. He was already not looking too good on the accuracy.
Oof. US getting close to a 97% average.
Oh, this is terrifying.
The US is pretty good on their average right now. Everyone's pretty close. Oh, Lord. Oh, Riven missed. And so did Finette.
Okay, we're about maybe halfway through the song now.
Yeah.
And it is just not looking fair. I think there's no other way to put it.
It's, I mean...
Just take a look at the average back. So that bar that you're seeing at the bottom, for those that haven't joined us earlier and have this explanation... that bar leans left and right depending on who has like a higher score or higher accuracy, etc. And it goes to like a percentage, basically, on how much they're winning. And I think the difference in how far that bar has gone, it is a solid line.
It speaks for itself. Oh. Lord.
Currently, missing more from Fnight. It is. A miss in there from Thanos. And, Rivian as well. Currently, the only one still holding a combo on
Dracona.
Is Dracona.
And Dracona's AK is just. It's not where it needs to be for this match.
No, it is
Dracona's not. Dracona's definitely a more challenged player.
This is...
Yeah, I mean, don't get me wrong. All these players are really good. It's just the US is just in another tier of their own. Like, Poland's definitely not doing bad.
Oh, the shit numbers that go into this. The US showing the powerhouse that they are. Just no real problem there.
They all got around the same act, too.
Yeah,
they all dropped a little bit at the end with like some of the faster little burst streams, but I don't think they were worried too much.
No, I think if they got a 96, they were satisfied with the scores they had there.
You guys almost had 3%.
I mean, none of them missed. That's a way to start the match.
Multiple misses from Team Poland there, just hammering that loss down even harder. This is gonna be a match.
I don't know what they're gonna pick, honestly. I honestly have no clue what they could pick.
I am really hoping they managed to get something.
The thing is, Sunrise, there's no way they'd win, period. All of the US players would get 97 and above, at least.
You know, I'm starting to think the other way
Esoteria
around.
Esoteria is a little... I don't know.
Because,
Esoteria is like Estrella's type of map is the problem.
Well, I think all of the American players can be fine on Esoteria. I don't think they'd have a problem with it. The only thing I can say about that is I also think both Esoteria and Avalanche are more likely for them to get any form of shitness on, which could possibly manage to flip it round if the Polish
feel
team
like... I feel like I Can't Breathe might get picked. It's got a lot of slider stuff that you could try and change stuff with. It's just really hard to find a way right now for Poland, honestly. I'm really trying to think of what they would want to pick.
I believe they can possibly get a match. Well, at least get one round off them, but I don't know how it's gonna go. This is one of those uphill battles that we see ever so commonly in a tournament situation where all that can really happen is that the lower players have to try and get a full combo, and then they just have to do as best as they can to keep the combo and do whatever they can while the other people... Just they gotta hope that the people better than them miss. That's all they can do. So it looks
I don't know. I feel like when it comes to shit miss and stuff, I feel like they'd want to go with I Can't Breathe.
They're going with the accuracy.
They're going with Sunrise.
They're going with the accuracy. Sunrise. What?
Oh boy.
That's
an interesting pick. That's an interesting pick. I honestly thought I Can't Breathe would be the only thing for Poland since there's so many diagonal jumps and random bursts of sliders in there. And then, you know, there's all the bombs in the beginning and towards the end where it's just all the spiral bombs that I thought I don't know. I don't think it's going to happen.
I reckon their plan here, because this is like easier to act on than something like Army, because Army's more techie. So I think what they're trying to bank on at the moment is that they can try and get some sort of similar act. Because it's like I was just saying of trying to like hold combo and then let the other people fail. But because the US's accuracy is that good, they have a safe space of, say, like three or four misses. So if they can get a map like Sunrise where they can more easily get good accuracy on it, that means that if they can hold a similar act to the US, the US are going to be punished far more if they miss than if they were doing something like Esoteria, where none of the Polish people can really act it apart from maybe Dracona. I think that's the only real plan they've got coming into this, but I don't see how that could transfer to any other maps in the category, so I can understand now why they picked Sunrise, but I don't think there's really much coming from this.
I want to see what ACK they'll get on this. I feel like all of them will get above a 97. When it comes to like the American side.
Yeah, they definitely have that safe space in terms of losing, but losing scores or by missing or whatever. But I think it's just down to how much the Americans try on this one. Because if they get too lax on this, then that's it.
Yeah, I want to see... I hope one or two of the American players get close to a 98, because I can get above a 97 on this map. So I really want to see one of them get like really high on it. Honestly speaking. Because this type of map, even though I got, you know, the 97, it's just, it's not my map. I actually do better on, you know, like Army.
Yeah, they've seemed to have... Wait, who have they swapped in now? They've swapped out Dracona and got in Sinking Ship and Jason Bourne. Well, Inborn.
And America did not change. That's an interesting choice.
Well, actually, no. America have swapped out Lux. Wait, no, they're not swapped out Luxus. Snowy's in there now. They swapped out.
Oh yeah, 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 yeah. That's what happened. It was Seraph for Snowy.
I knew someone had changed. Okay, this is gonna be interesting to see how this goes then.
Oh, that 98% average. Freaking Xerix is really up there.
Yeah, they've got Xerix in as well now. And I believe Xerix is fairly good at ACK. I'm not sure.
Well, they have blood control.
Have you seen any of the Poland players, specifically like Thanos, Jason Inborn, and Sinking Ship before?
I've seen Jason Inborn on a few ACK maps, but they were like mid tech type stuff, and he wasn't super high on them. I don't really remember Thanos besides on like a few newer leaderboards. Fnit or Fnite is just, I've seen him in a few tournaments. He's pretty decent. I have not seen Sinking Ship, but I assume since they swapped for Dracono, he's a better tech player or ACK player than Dracono, which seems to be true so far.
Yeah, there seems to be, at the moment, I'm getting about almost towards a minute in, just past it. It seems that all of the players are fairly comfortable with
Estrella missed, actually.
Aha. Uh-huh.
And see, Lux had a bad swing. Lux had a bad swing too, which brought him down.
It looked like Lux had another bad swing.
Actually.
Yeah, currently looking at some of the people on Team Poland, they're about 97-ish on Fnite, 96.3 on Thanos, Inborn 96.3 as well.
I really thought Luxus would get like a 97.5 at least.
Yeah, the only problem here is even with the bad cuts and misses, their accuracy is just so much better.
Oh yeah, they're still a percent ahead. But I mean, Poland's definitely doing pretty good still. Even with Jason missing just then, they still are only a little less than a percent behind. But a percent is a lot when it comes to ACK. It's going to be really hard for that average to go up.
So close. It doesn't take much to sway it in one direction or another. Oh no. It's all of them just have no problem acting on something like this. So it's genuinely,
I know
that just
is
a matter of comfort.
Snowy's type of map. Because Snowy is a little more techie than me.
So it seems like Jason Inborn actually missed. His ACK already
wasn't the best
on there. It seems like he's swinging somewhat too far to the right for some reason on his right saber. Seems to be tilted outwards a bit.
Knight just doing a little dance there. Estrella looking sad that he missed a note, but I mean, he still got close to a 97, so I wouldn't complain too much.
My ACK was popping off anyway, I 97'd it anyway.
I mean, honestly, if Knight's gonna dance, he might as well dance. He can have fun with that.
Yes, he did.
Did you miss?
Oh, it's seeing coming to the end.
Oh, yeah, like interns. Our inter said right there, ACK is pretty stressful on stream.
Hearing the audio immediately from the American team, Estrella gets unmuted first out of everyone on his team and instantly says that he doesn't want to talk about it. He is very unhappy.
Hey, I did not include the in that time, all right? But yeah, I mean, I do way worse on ACK in tournaments too. I get too shaky.
Coming to the end of that, what?
I still really thought Lux would get a 97 or above, though.
Yeah, and that is the second round. Well, second map going to Poland. They are really in a hole here. The only plans that they've come up with to try and throw the US off, which was first going for something shit missy through tech, then going to for accuracy and hoping they miss, which they did miss, but I mean, Estrella still got a 97. I don't know where they're going to go from here. And this is the US's... Well, is this going to be the US's...
I mean, well? I don't want to say it can't get any worse, but... it can. So I'm just not...
I think the next one is just going to be down to what can they jam out to the most? What are they going to pick to...
Xerix is in chat with his egg.
Oh, no. Yeah, it's Poland's map pick again, so I think for this third map, they're either going to try for Avalanche, I reckon. Avalanche, sure, I can't breathe. Yeah, actually, no, they might try for any of these maps.
For those saying it's almost over, by the way, we do have another match after this.
That is true. Oh, I don't know what they're going to pick, because I think all of these are fair picks to try and throw something off. You can see the chat on the left there, Senorank also does not know.
I have no clue.
Oh,
I just honestly feel like, I don't think it'll be good no matter what they pick, but if I was like in the position, I would pick I Can't Breathe.
Yeah, I think...
I feel like Esoteria is like, it's fast, but
pattern-wise,
you know, it'd be fine for the American players.
Avalanche and Esoteria is just going to be the same approach of play it, try and get a better combo than Americans, try and hope that they miss more. I Can't Breathe is a slight bit less of that, but I think either way, just from those previous two performances, their plans are just not happening. They already knew that they were coming into a very bad matchup.
I'm sorry, but it's just one of those matches, sadly.
Oh, come on, still got hope. We still gotta get hope for him.
I'll give him hope.
They have one more attempt to try and steal a match from the Earth.
And they picked I Can't Breathe.
I Can't Breathe has been picked. They did not take the speedy option. They did not take the tech stream option. We are going for I Can't Breathe, which we have not seen yet.
Dracona's coming back. So the only difference for the Poland team is they switched out Sinking Ship with Dracona. And Estrella... they pretty much changed all of the team, actually, except for Xerix for the US, because now Sarah, Galakan, and Schwenk are in there.
Okay, right.
Schwenk, I can't speak today.
So the US team has just done a backflip. Whoops has switched everyone out. He is unhappy with the performance. There were no 98s on that previous
match. Oh, yeah, they're all getting the belt.
Yeah, so we have Sarah, Galakan, Xyrex, and Schwenk.
So if there is tracking, such as the teleporting saber, the call
transition
comes from Whoops.
Estrella's just
final say of whether to call it or not.
Practicing some hardcore challenge maps real quick with his noodle slate sabers.
Oh, noodle sabers, that's what we want to see. I wonder how long it's going to take before we get some meme matches going on in here. And by that, I mean the sabers. I know that at some point, someone's going to use some really dumb sabers.
Probably.
Dumb sabers or environments. Oh, God. Imagine if we had had a World Cup back in the day.
Logan
coming in with, like, the environments where you genuinely could not see.
Oh, my God. I mean, not saying I wouldn't watch it, but I'd actually want to watch that. That'd be pretty funny. I honestly wouldn't be surprised someone using some random dumb sabers, because maybe it's a mental move, you know? They see dumb sabers and they're like, oh, my stress is just relieved now. This isn't serious. So, you know, they're not as nervous anymore. It's all in the mental game. Oh, boy. Well, I can't breathe.
I hope the Polish have any sort of clue what they're doing here.
Here we go. Noodle, okay. Noodle.
The green screens begin.
Still, Schwank still has his cursor on screen. Or a cursor.
Maybe it's not even his cursor. Maybe he's just stolen it.
Probably not. Schwank is, right now, he's swinging very slowly as if he's trying to ack it, which he does have a 96. But it does look like he's using more arm right now. Ooh. Knight just already missed. Ooh. Inserted sinking ship and Thanos.
Oh no!
There goes all those bombs I was talking about.
They couldn't make it any harder for themselves. No!
Thanos has an 83. 84. Mm. US team with an average of 96.
96 and Poland's under an SS. No, this isn't how it's meant to go.
Oh, Lord.
This isn't a sweep. This is a massacre.
At least they're getting back up now a little bit. I don't want to see it go down that badly.
Oh no.
But yeah, I mean, it's a good song. It's definitely a good song, at least. All those slider sections. I'd be more worried about the little, switch at the top that happens. Ooh, Sarah just missed. And ooh. So did Yaoken, actually, at the part, yeah, I was talking about.
And Fnite also missing just a bit before.
That little switch up top right after the sliders gets me all the time.
Sarah missing again. By the looks of things, their plan to pick this so that the Americans would miss a bit is paying off, but the problem is they are too. It's backfiring. The plan's working, dragging the Americans' accuracy down to a 95.6, which is, I believe, the lowest we've seen it in any of these matches, excluding the warm-ups before that. Currently about halfway through the song.
Oh. Yeah, Dracono's got a pretty good ack right now. He's actually close to Yaoken's score.
Dracono and Schwank, both holding that full combo. Oh, actually, Xyrex as well, also holding that combo.
Yeah, I honestly feel like this is another one of a good pick for Xyrex, just due to the fact that maps that aren't insanely fast and they're more like techie or just complex like this, he usually does pretty well on.
Well,
and he's actually shaking
right
his head there for his lack of ack, he said.
Let's be honest, there's no pick currently in this pool, at the very least. There is no pick that does not favor the Americans.
Oh, yeah.
At all. There is... Everything in here has at least like two people in their team that can happily deal with it, and at least 100%. Another two people that can happily just ack it. It does not matter what it is. The Polish came into this match trying to get at least one round off of the Americans, and it is just not going to plan.
Oh, it's just... Oh no. Americans all got above a 95 again after those misses. Oh. Poland has at least gone back up to above a 92.
Poland has at least recovered their team's accuracy to be above the SS margin.
Yeah. They still,
but it is not real,
still 3% difference.
3% difference. Putting an end to the Poland versus USA matchup. GG the sweep.
Where yeah,
the
just
US
wanna...
did not just beat them up, they just grabbed them and massacred them.
Strangled.
There was no...
Oh, Lord.
No pity there.
I'm just looking at Xyrex's score, that 96.4 on that map. That was actually really, really good.
Yeah.
This would be second.
Wait, Xyrex just set the new number one score on that map at the same time.
Did he?
Oh no.
Lord.
Oh wait. No, he just beat it. He just got the... So the score he just got was actually second on the leaderboard. This was below his PB. That's why he was shaking his head.
His previous best? Oh, I was about to say, I thought I saw him up there on the leaderboard when I went to play it earlier.
Yeah, he played that match before we actually got into it. He played that while everyone else was playing their match, I believe. Got a 96.6. Then he got picked. So he moved in to play it, and then gets a 96.4, so no wonder
he's sad. Lord.
But that is going to be Poland knocked down from that match versus the US and to lose this round one.
Oh, the GGs in chat.
Oh. That is GG for the attempt from Poland.
The next people that the United States will have to play will either be Japan or South Korea.
Oh, those teams could be scarier. But as it
oh, is, yeah. I mean, Japan doesn't have Tai Chi, but they're still pretty good. They're still pretty decent.
So, Poland had a video which they made, and they want to display on the stream to everyone. This was made before the match just happened.
This was their reaction to the match.
Yeah, for anyone that's been active in the World Cup Discord, you will have seen this already. We all know what's coming, and if you don't, you're in for a treat. So.
Y me llama el cocinero.
Recita, oh God, ¿qué? Here we go.
Ve por la paellera, venga, que las 2 de la tarde ya están aquí. Miren, bañador, en las chanclas. Todo despeinado porque no me dio tiempo de nada ponerme las chanclas y el bañador.
Here we go, he's the...
Voy a la playa, había subido la marea.
I love this video so much.
Y cuando entro en el restaurante me ve el cocinero con una paellera y adentro la vende paellera. ¡Asómate! ¡Asómate! ¡Mira dónde llega el agua! ¡Llegaba el agua hasta el restaurante! ¡Había subido la marea! ¡Ay! ¡Eso! ¡Hay que hacer más! Salió la bien de regla, estamos llorando los dos. Me cobró el tío la. Me cobró a 500 veces. Y ya no fui más. Me fui andando a cuello amarillo hasta hoy. Eso. Me mató. Me mandó por la noche, había bajado más el agua y por la mañana había subido. Cualquiera estaba donde está la paellera, a lo mejor está en el barco ese del petróleo.
En el Prestige.
En el Petriense. Y ya no trabajé más la cocina. Ya aburrí sin la cocina. Ay, no cobré nada, me dieron el dinero del bote.
¿Había mucho dinero en el bote?
Lo que me echaban y el dinero de lo que gané, me cobraron 20 paelleras. A 500 caras, pues viste lo que me llevé yo para Sevilla. Ay, ya aborrecí la playa. Hemos llorado los dos. Ya te tú, no pa' tanto yo. A ti yo no quiero arroz, tú, yo no quiero arroz ni en China, vamos.
Video's still good even the second time or third time.
Oh, it's always good. And with that amazing video from Team Poland, I shall be taking my leave and leaving you in the worthwhile hands of Walden, who will be taking over for me for the next match. So thank you everyone, and I shall disappear for now.
Goodbye,
good luck to the next teams. And
see you, man.